I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you.
Good afternoon, and welcome to the Eric C. Ransom Junior Police Academy graduation for class 2024-1. First and foremost, I'd like to say thank you to you parents and guardians of our young graduates. You gave us your trust this week to instill discipline and knowledge into your kids, and we appreciate your willingness to do that. This week was not easy. It's designed to test them physically, mentally, emotionally, and psychologically. They all passed. You all passed. You should be very proud of yourselves, because we all are. Before we go any further, I'd like to introduce Detective Bill Petrovi to speak a little bit about the Eric C. Ransom Junior Police Academy.
Thank you. Eric C. Ransom transferred to the Woodbridge Police Department in 1999. He quickly became a monumental figure with our department, especially once he entered the Juvenile Aid Bureau. Eric served the community with tough love and treated every juvenile he encountered as if they were one of his own. He would let a kid know that they messed up, but he would also work with them in an effort to get them on a good life path. Eric was instrumental in the Junior Police Academy program, where he served as lead drill instructor for more than 10 years. This is where his hard work and dedication really shined. He was both a drill instructor and father figure to so many young men and women. He poured his heart and soul into the youth of our community on a daily basis. If there was one person you did not let down, it was Detective Ransom. His love for the community spilled into the numerous boys and girls programs, most of which catered to middle school and high school students in need. Along with his best friend and partner, Woodbridge Police Detective Mark Zeno, Eric was a mentor to teenagers in need of guidance and discipline. His efforts successfully set many young people in the right direction, changing their outlook on life and helping them move away from defiant behavior. His energy and love were unmatched. As if his resume and character weren't already impressive enough, Eric was also a member of the United States Marine Corps and United States Army, with 38 years of dedicated service. His love for his country also led him to become a proud member and main figure in the North Jersey Young Marines program. The world would be a better place if it were filled with Eric Ransoms. We should be humbly reminded that while that may be true, it wouldn't have made Eric as special as he was. There was no truer statement than that. 2 years ago was unfortunately Eric's final Junior Police Academy. He endured the 2 weeks of mentoring and training while in a tremendous amount of pain, but he gutted it out. Eric was dedicated to the task at hand and refused to let anyone down. Shortly after last year's Junior Police Academy, Detective Ransom was diagnosed with cancer. He fought hard, hurdle after hurdle, but unfortunately Eric Ransom passed away peacefully on Wednesday, April 19, 2023, surrounded by his loving family. All of our love goes out to Detective Ransom's family. We know that if he left this type of impression on his colleagues and community, he's even more special to his family. He left big shoes for us to fill, and we will do our best to carry on his legacy. Detective Eric C. Ransom, number 461, will always be honored and never forgotten. After Eric's passing, it hit us hard and continues to weigh on our hearts, but Eric would want us to drive on. The Detective Bureau leaned on each other for support and began discussing ways to always honor Detective Ransom, because he was such a monumental figure to so many. I stand here today a better person for having Eric Ransom in my life. Our decision was that any one thing just wasn't enough. It was only fitting that the Junior Police Academy be named in his honor and logo recreated. I truly hope that all of you wore those shirts with pride and will continue on a positive path in life, school, and whatever profession you choose in the future. Eric C. Ransom was the backbone of the Junior Police Academy. As you look out, you will see the Woodbridge Police Department's rendition of a battlefield cross crafted in Eric's honor by fellow officers. The cross consists of a spine, Eric's drill instructor hat, his boots, and challenge coin at the base. We also wanted you, you cadets to part with something to always remember Detective Eric C. Ransom and the Junior Police Academy. We truly hope that you will cherish the challenge coin, which was also created by fellow officers in Eric's honor, and to show our appreciation to all of you for successfully completing this week's challenges. One side, you will see Eric C. Ransom Junior Police Academy name with raised Woodbridge Police Department patch. Other side, you will see Eric's silhouette rendering a salute in front of our nation's flag with his date of birth and end of watch. The thin blue line symbolizing dedication to his profession. The words dedication, respect, honor, courage, integrity, and loyalty, which are all values that he wished to teach and instill in our youth. Lastly, it states, an honored memory of Eric C. Ransom, number 461, an inspiration to all who knew him. What a true statement that is. I know he's watching and is very proud of us all. We love and miss you dearly, but in honor, we'll take it from here. Till we meet again, love your brothers and sisters of the Woodbridge Police Department. I'd like to add a personal story that I had today. Detective Harris sent me out to get coffee and donuts, because cops like coffee and donuts, for the instructors, because they were a little hungry and thirsty. I stopped over at the Dunkin' Donuts on Route 35 in Hyatt, and the cashier there, probably about 18, 19 years old, jokingly says, "Is this for the department?" I said, "Well, no, it's for the Junior Police Academy." And fittingly enough, he said, "You know, I graduated from the Police Academy 2019, and Detective Ransom was my instructor." And he apologized and, you know, offered me the his condolences for Eric's passing. And he said because of the Junior Police Academy, he keeps himself in shape, he works a part-time job, he goes to school, and he wants to make something of himself. So even today, it's fitting enough, Eric still touches us in a positive way, even beyond. So I just thought I'd share that with all of you today, and I hope all the graduates remember that as they move forward in life. And with that, I'll turn it back over to Detective Harris.
Kudos for being able to read that out loud. Oof. This time I'd like to introduce the Director Hubner, who is the police director for the police department.
Thank you. Afternoon. First off, congratulations to our graduates. And as Detective Harris said, thank you for trusting us this week. They persevered. Monday morning is chaos when they come in here. A lot of yelling and screaming. It's just madness. But the week went by, and now you see a well-oiled machine. Outstanding job. Great job. I'd like to thank our community affairs officers, all the officers that volunteered, and all our civilian volunteers that made this a great success. I'd like to thank Mayor McCormick for supporting this along with our council. But several years ago, Mayor McCormick actually partook and spent a day or two in the Junior Police Academy. I pretty much thought my career was over. But if he wants to tell that story, I'll let him. But again, congratulations to them all, and thank you.
Now we'll hear from Mayor John McCormick.
No, you will not hear the story of the days I spent in the Junior Police Academy. They were quite embarrassing. I want to quickly introduce we have our chief of staff with us, Karen Ehrlich, for a former council person. We have Councilwoman Lisbeth DeJesus.
Dan is.
Oh, and Dan Harris is here from the Board of Education, the board president. And our chief law enforcement officer, Brian Murphy, is with us. So congratulations, you just went through a very difficult week, but I know you're proud of yourself for having done that. I'm sure when you went home Monday night, there were many of you that were questioning whether you wanted to come back on Tuesday morning. But you did. You did. And that says something about you. Yeah, as you heard from Officer Harris, you learned an awful lot this week. And I really want to say congratulations, but I want you to know that you just learned from what I truly believe is the best police department in the state of New Jersey. I don't just say that. Every 3 years, we're looked at by a national organization that comes in with people from anywhere from Montana to Arizona and in between. They don't know us. We don't know them. They look at us every single policy, procedure, practice. They look at us up and down and always give us glowing recommendations. We always have ceremonies where we honor officers for life-saving and for heroic actions. Tuesday night, I saw it in action. Tuesday night, I was at the concert, a hot night, and it was intermission, and a lady literally dropped to the ground and was blue and had no pulse and was not breathing. And our officers were there within seconds. They were right there within seconds. Then they immediately took control of the situation and they delivered CPR to her. And by the time she got in the ambulance, she had a pulse and she was breathing. By the time she got to the hospital, she was breathing better and had a better pulse. And she spent a night or two, but is doing fine now because of, and I saw it. I always give these awards out and I read what happened. But in this case, I saw it. This police department is the best in the state, and you just learned from the best in the state. So I want to thank Officer Harris, Officer Santoni, all the officers there. You didn't just graduate from the Junior Police Academy, you graduated from the Woodbridge Junior Police Academy, and that says a whole lot. And to all of you parents and grandparents, you've heard it before, trusting your kids with us. Everybody knows middle school, fifth, sixth, seventh, and eighth grades are times when kids can go in the right direction, kids can go in the wrong direction. Your kids are going in the right direction, and you should be proud of that. I've had so many parents tell me over the years that the Junior Police Academy changed their kids' life. I believe it. I've seen it. I hear it. And we talk, you heard Officer Petrovi talk about Eric, and I've had people tell me that Eric, outside of the police academy, because of the work he did with families on the side, changed people's lives. That's what we have here in Woodbridge. We have the kind of dedicated officers that are not just day-to-day police officers, but they go above and beyond and do terrific things for the community, and you just saw it happen with your kid or your grandkid. So thank you for having the trust in us, and thanks once again for the best police department in the state of New Jersey for doing this.
As always, I'd like to thank our police administration, the mayor's office, the town council, and of course, the Avenel Middle School staff and custodial staff for their assistance and support this week. We couldn't have done it without you guys. This program clearly does not run itself. Thank you to my staff, to my left over here, your right, Officer Santoni. Where are you at? Wave your hand, Nate. He's behind me. There he is, he's back there. Thank you. Okay, now they're all to my left here. Mike Liskowski, Kayla Ruiz, Megan Krishpa, Madison Krishpa, and Megan Krishpa, and Chris Kuzar. I couldn't have done it without you, any of you, and you made this week flow pretty flawlessly, so I have to thank you for that. Thank you so much. And to our 100% Marine Corps drill instructor staff, I'm an Army guy, so it kills me to say that. But kudos to you gentlemen. You guys, once again, a flawless job. I would like to recognize them. Officer Dave Ricardo. Detective Michael Broll. Officer Marcio Amaro. Officer Stephen Doyle. And Detective Promotable Mark Sokolo. You guys say oorah, oorah, gentlemen. And to you graduates, you found it within yourselves to push through. You fought off the urge to quit. You said, I'm a winner, and it pays to be a winner. Take it away, drill instructor Ricardo. Ladies and gentlemen, that concludes today's ceremony. Your graduates are just retrieving their personal gear, and they'll be returning back to the cafeteria momentarily.